जैन फ्रेंड्स, होप यू ऑल आर एंजॉइंग योर स्टडी एंड डूइंग वेल एट योर होम। सो डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द 11th सम ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 12.3 व्हिच इज एरिया रिलेटेड टू सर्कल्स। दोस्तों, आप लोग अपने इस एक्सरसाइज में, ये जो एक्सरसाइज 12.3 है, दिस इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर बोर्ड एग्जाम, सो बी केयरफुल and study well. In this question number 11th, it is given that on a square handkerchief, 9 circular designs, each of radius 7 cm are made as in the figure it is given. Then find the area of remaining portion of the handkerchief. ठीक है ना दोस्तों? So इसका figure पहले हम देखते हैं, as it is given, what this is a square ABCD. In this square ABCD, nine congruent circles are drawn of the same. Congruent circle means their radii are same, means it is equals to 7 cm. Now question is asking, find the area of remaining portion of handkerchief. It means out of this handkerchief, squared handkerchief, we have to exclude the area of these 9 circles. So to find out the remaining portion, area of remaining portion, first of all we have to decide the what is the side of, what is the length of the side of square. So the length of side of a square is equals to 3 times the diameter of the circle, right friends? As the radius of circle is given 7 cm, so diameter of one circle will be equals to 14 cm. So we are going to find out the length of diameter of length of side of a square is equals to 3 multiplied by diameter of the one circle, and 3 multiplied by diameter of the circle is equals to 2 into radius of the circle. This is the radius of the circle, right friends? Okay, so 3 2 is 6 into radius of the circle, that is 7. 7 6 are 42 cm is the side of this square handkerchief, right friends? Now we are going to find out the area of a square, and area of a square is equals to length of side of the square, which is square of length of the side, which is 42 cm². That is equals to, when you multiply 42 into 42 is equals to 1764 cm². Now we need to find out the area of these 9 circles that we are going to exclude from this handkerchief, right? So area of 9 circles, to find out the area of 9 circle, first we need to find out the area of one circle, which is pi r square. Okay friends, so area of pi r square, that is pi, the value of pi is 22/7, and r square, the radius of circle is 7, so which is equals to 7 into 7. We multiply, so we will get the area of one circle, that is equals to 154 cm². So to get the area of 9 circle, we should multiply it by 9. So therefore area of 9 circle is equals to 9 multiplied by area of one circle, which is 154, that is equals to 1386 cm², right friends? Now we are going to come on the topic, which is area of remaining portion of handkerchief. So to find out the area of remaining portion of handkerchief, we have to create our formula, that is equals to area of a square handkerchief minus area of 9 circle. And area of a square handkerchief, as we have already find, 1764 minus area of 9 circle, which is 1386. When we subtract, you will get area of remaining portion of the handkerchief is 378 cm². So friends, answer of this question is area of remaining part of the handkerchief is 378 cm². Right friends, I hope you will understood and solve it well in your notebook. Okay friends, so let us see the question number 12th, solution of question number 12th of exercise 12.3. which is given in the figure OACB is a quadrant of a circle with center O and radius 3.5 cm. If OD is equals to 2 cm, OD means this part of the circle is of quadrant is given. OD is 2 cm, then find the area of first quadrant OACB, area of quadrant, and after that area of shaded region. Right, friends? So area of quadrant, to find out the area of quadrant, we know that the area, that angle at the center of a quadrant is 90 degrees. As the radius of this quadrant is given 3.5 cm, so area of quadrant OACB is equals to theta upon 360 pi r square. Right, friends? So therefore area of quadrant is equals to theta upon 360 into pi r square. Theta is 90 degrees, as a quadrant is giving. Therefore pi is the 90 upon 360, which is 1/4. Pi is 22/7, and radius is 3.5, which is equals to 7.5 square, means multiplied it by 2 times. When we simplify, you will get the area of this quadrant is 77/8 cm². Right, friends? So the answer of first question, area of quadrant OACB is equals to 77/8 cm². Now the second question is given, the area of shaded region we are going to find out. So dear friends, to find the area of this shaded region, we have to find out this area of triangle OBD. After getting the area of this triangle OBD, we have to subtract this area of triangle OBD from the area of quadrant OACB. So we will get the area of shaded region. Okay. So first of all, we have to find out the area of triangle ODB, which is equals to half into base into height. If you are taking OB is equals to base, so OD will be the height. Or OD is the base, so OB will be the height. Therefore, here it is taken half into BO into OD. The measure of these two sides are given 3.5 and 2. So area of triangle ODB is equals to half into 3.5 into 2, which is equals to 7/2 cm² is the area of this triangle. Right, friends? So let us find out the area of shaded part. So area of shaded part is equals to area of quadrant OACB minus area of triangle OBD. So that is equals to 77/8 minus 7/2 cm². So which is equals to, taking 8 as LCM, 77 minus 2 4s are 8 and 4 7s are 28 cm², which is equals to 49/8 cm². Right, friends? So we got the area of shaded portion 49/8 cm². I hope you all understood well. Pause the video and note it down there in your notebook. Okay, friends, see the question number 13 of the exercise 12.3. Dear friends, see the figure, and according to the figure we have to get the idea how to get the area of this shaded region. In the figure, a square OABC, a square OABC, here it is given, this square is visible clearly, OABC is a square. In this figure, OABC is inscribed in a quadrant OBPQ. If OA is equals to 20 cm, then find the area of this shaded region. Right, friends? So to get the area of this shaded region, first of all we need to find out the radius of this quadrant part. ठीक है? तो इस क्वाड्रेंट पार्ट का रेडियस फाइंड करने के लिए वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट द डायगोनल ऑफ दिस स्क्वायर, एंड दिस डायगोनल गिव्स यू द रेडियस ऑफ दिस सर्कुलर पार्ट. राइट? So to find out the radius of this circle or diagonal of this square, we use the Pythagoras theorem. In a square OABC, OA is equals to AB is equals to BC is equals to OC, which is 20 centimeter, that is given. Okay? So let us find out the measure of OB that gives the radius of this circle, which is equals to, by the Pythagoras theorem, square of hypotenuse is equals to the sum of the square of the other two sides. So OB square is equals to OA square plus AB square. OB square is equals to OA square plus AB square, which is 20 square plus 20 square, that is 800. So OB square is equals to 800. That gives you OB is equals to 20 root 2, that is the square root of 800. Now radius of this quadrant is 20 root 2 centimeter. This is the radius, 20 root 2 centimeter. Right friends, 20 root 2 centimeter. So this is the cancel, because radius is in centimeter only, not centimeter square. So now we are going to find out the area of this quadrant OPBQ. Area of OPBQ, and area of OPBQ, this is the quadrant part, means 1/4 part of area of circle. So 1/4 pi, the value of pi is given 3.14, which is equals to 314 upon 100, and radius is 20 root 2 whole square. Now simplify it, we will get the area of OPBQ is equals to 628 centimeter square. So that we need to find out the area of shaded region is equals to area of quadrant minus area of this square. Right friends, area of quadrant OPBQ minus area of square OABC. So area of this quadrant 628 centimeter square, and area of square is side square, which is 20 square, that is 628 centimeter square minus 400 gives you 228 centimeter square. So friends, area of this shaded portion is equals to 228 centimeter square. Right friends, I hope you all understood these questions. So, pause the video and note it down there in your notebook.